What's going on, everybody? It's Ozzy from Ozzox Hardware, and here with me, I have the new Pixio PX277, a 27-inch 2560 by 1440 monitor with IPS, a 144Hz refresh rate, and FreeSync. Oh, and it's only $399. Not much is known about Pixio, and that's because they are a newer company. According to their website, they were founded in 2016 by hardcore gamers who wanted to cater enthusiast features to the masses by making them more affordable and implementing them into cheaper products. And they definitely fulfilled the enthusiast features promise, in my opinion. There are some monitors that combat the Pixio PX277, but they usually lack a feature or two that makes the Pixio stand out. For instance, the Acer XG27 uses a 144Hz and 2560 by 1440 panel, but lacks an IPS screen. The Asus MG279Q is the next cheapest monitor that supports all the features found on the Pixio, hovering around $550. Of course, enthusiast features does not necessarily mean enthusiast quality. The last version of the PX277, the one that came out in August or September of last year, had very similar specifications to this model, but it was riddled with issues. It had backlight bleeding issues, it had a very thick and frankly ugly bezel, it had a weak monitor stand, and it had a high chance of dead pixels. Fortunately enough, Pixio analyzed a lot of the issues with the previous generation, and they fixed most of them. The monitor, starting off, looks phenomenal. The sleek casing and thinner bezels fit display trends we see today and allow it to fit and complement any modern day setups very nicely. It's bare minus the new PX277 logo on the bottom left, which, side rant, I'm not a fan of the name. Instead of PX277, perhaps something like PX278 could have been more appropriate, just so it's easier for the buyer to differentiate this current gen model from the previous generation. But anyway, I digress. On the right side, you have your menu button, your up and down arrows, a back button, and a power button. And on the back of the monitor, you have your monitor specifications, the well-placed Pixio logo, 1 display port, and 2 HDMI ports. The metal stand is a nice upgrade from last year's model. It's sturdier and much denser. And you can tilt the monitor about 16 degrees in either direction of the normal. And that kind of sounds small, but in reality, it's much more than anyone who's using a main desktop monitor would tilt. So it's perfectly fine. If you're not a fan of the stand and mount that come with the monitor, then you're in luck because the Pixio supports the standard VESA mount. So you have a lot of options to choose from. Now, most 144Hz monitors, and I believe all 1080p ones, use TN panels, which is totally fine for high refresh gaming. It doesn't have the best color accuracy, but between it, VA panels, and IPS panels, it's generally regarded as the most responsive. But if you're like me, where you're a content creator first and casual gamer second, then a TN panel probably wouldn't cut it, and IPS would be a better choice, which this monitor has. You get better color accuracy, better viewing angles, and a higher dynamic range, which allow you to view your work in a more accurate setting than on a TN panel. And Pixio did not cut corners in responsiveness simply because it's an IPS panel. Wendell from Level 1 Techs actually reviewed the monitor, and if you haven't seen it, then definitely go check it out. But they did a hard latency test of the monitor, and they concluded that, and I quote, that it is unbelievably insanely good. The monitor only introduced about an extra millisecond of delay. That's fantastic. So the fact that the PX277 has a high refresh rate, a higher resolution than most monitors out there today, and it also has the IPS panel for great color accuracy and editing makes it a jack of all trades, in all honesty. I can edit videos and I can still play fast-paced titles like Overwatch and Rainbow Six Siege and still feel like I'm not missing out on either of those experiences. And then there's FreeSync on top of all of that, and it has that huge FreeSync range. The range spans from 30Hz to 144Hz, so essentially 99% of the games that you play will be within that range. So even if you can't hit that 144fps threshold, you still have adaptive sync technology to back you up and prevent screen tearing, so
you're set for pretty much all the games that you'll play.
So it's very obvious that Pixio has a winner on their hands here, but it doesn't come without a few shortcomings. For one, the monitor has IPS glow, and it's not too noticeable. It's only really noticeable when it's dark and all of my lights are off, but it's definitely still there. Now, I haven't actually experienced any backlight bleeding, but I know some people that have, so just keep that in mind. Secondly, Pixio could improve on the viewing angles. If I tilt my head about 10 degrees to the left or the right, then I get this really weird color feathering effect on the edge of the monitor screen. In Google Documents, for example, if I tilt my head about 10 to maybe 15 degrees to the right, then on the left side of the panel, I have this really weird blue or feather effect that's pretty visible. Now, it only covers a small area of the monitor, and like I mentioned, it only happens when I tilt my head about 10 degrees and beyond, which I won't do much when I'm editing or even gaming, but it's still something that you guys should be aware of. And lastly, the color accuracy isn't the top of the line. It's definitely good enough for about 98% of content creators, so like myself, I'm totally okay with it, but if you're very particular and you want your colors to be as accurate as possible to the teeth, first of all, you're probably not gonna be looking at this monitor at this price. You probably want something a little bit more expensive, but in case you are on a budget, then you might wanna look elsewhere. According to Adobe's color accuracy software, I believe, I think it has a 78% match rating with Adobe, which again is good enough for 98% of people who are content creators. But if you want something super accurate and very realistic, then this probably isn't the right monitor for you. For $399, I highly recommend it. And I believe 2 or 3 weeks ago, maybe even earlier than that, it was around $350. So at that price, it's definitely worth it. And I expect it to drop down to that again with holidays coming around. So if you're in the market for a new monitor, then definitely check out this one. It could be right for you. But that's it for this video, guys. If you guys enjoyed it, then leave a like. And if you loved it, share and subscribe and all of that stuff. Thank you guys so much for watching. I have another monitor-esque video coming out kind of soon. I'm working on that right now. We'll see how that goes. But if you want to know about that a little bit more and be there when it uploads, then click that subscribe button. Anyway, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.